dear students, in last class we have understood a short story Or Manushan by Vaikom Muhammad Bashir. Today I have come back to explain you, to teach you another poem, that is If I Was a Tree, which is originally written in Kannada by Moodnapuru Chinnaswamy, and that has been translated into English by Rowan Hill. So before going to discuss the poem, let us know about the poet, the author of the poem If I Was a Tree by Moodnapuru Chinnaswamy. So Moodnapuru Chinnaswamy, born in the year of 1954 in one of the villages of Chamarajanagar district of Karnataka state. The name of the village is Moodnapuru, and he had two master degrees for his M.Com and M.A. and he has completed D.Litt Doctors of Letters in Social Science, and he served Moodnapuru Chinnaswamy. His professionally, he was a director of finance in BMTC, Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation. By professional, he was a director of finance in BMTC, Bangalore Metropolitan Transport Corporation. He worked as a director, and he was very passionate. He had passion of writing poetry. Not only he had passion of writing poetry, and at the same time he was interested in other genre of literature, other forms of literature, like culture, theater, and he was a social, in a social work also he had interest, and he has brought out 24 books, including poetry, four of essays, and three plays and collection of short stories. His works have been widely translated, not only into English, now in Indian languages, and English and Spanish and Hebrew also. And is an anthology, a collection of poems have been published in Spanish by the government of Venezuela, which is one of the country in South America. In that world poetry series, in that, in his anthology, his collection of poems have been published in Spanish by the government of Venezuela. Right now, Moodnapuru Chinnaswamy is a retired. He has been retired from his post. Was working as a director of finance in BMTC. Now he is involving in other activities, like he was dedicated to write or participating in progress as an activist. The social work he is involving himself, and this poem If I Was a Tree is translated by Rowan Hill from England. She is a very good translator. She translated in English as well as in Spanish. So many of works she has translated from Kannada into English and Spanish. So now if you come back to the poem If I Was a Tree, writer is expressing his anger, his disappointment, his frustration, about the discrimination based on a caste in Indian society. This poem is against, it's a protest against the evil caste system which has been practicing in Indian society. Dear students, poet believed that in the nature there is no such practice of discrimination on color, size, gender or habitat, then why this discrimination existed in society? And there shall be no such practice in the society. Countries like India, there has been discrimination, suppression, dominance on the name of caste and creed. So naturally, poet feels here, he feels ashamed being born as a human being. Instead, he wanted to become a tree. Moondakodu Chinnaswamy feels that he wanted to become a tree instead of a human being. Unlike human being who born in a lower class or a lower caste, and he will have the bitter experience of discrimination based on caste, but that never happens with a tree. And he says that he believed that there is no such practice existed in the nature, then why it existed in human beings? So here he talks about defilement and purification. Through this poem, he tries to convey, and he attempts to convey, that the defilement and purifications are unethical, they are prejudiced. We have created them because they have not existed in the nature. They never happen with other creatures. They are happening only with human beings because they are unethical and they are prejudiced. And that should not happen. And he brings out two imagery through tree. He tries to convey through two imageries of tree and a holy cow. Tree and a holy cow. He feels that if I was a tree, what would have happened? If I was a tree, the birds would have not asked before going to build their nest in me. They would have not asked which caste I am. So here, I means poet himself has become the narrator. The character here means that he wishes to become a tree rather than a human being. He feels that if I was a tree, birds would have not asked before building or before built their nest in me, they would have not asked which caste I am. This poem is expressing the reality that the discrimination before going to in the society, what happens? The caste acts more than anything else sometimes, so that he feels ashamed being born as a human being. Rather, instead he wanted to become a tree. And next he tells that the sun's beams which fall on the tree, the shadow of the tree would have not felt defilement. friendship. Next he tells them, a friendship with a cool breeze would make me sweet, and the raindrops which fall on me would never consider me as a dog eater. As a dog eater. Dog eater means the person who born, or it means that the person who born in a very low class, low caste. And it is another way of treating someone so badly. So, if the birds would have not asked, if I was a tree, the birds would not ask me which caste I am. The sun's beams would not, they would have not felt defilement. The cool breeze likes my sweet company. The raindrops would never consider me as a dog eater. And if I start spreading my branches, the mother earth would not, or she never flee, run away to take bath. And he says that a sacred cow, a sacred cow, whenever it feels itches, it comes to me and scrapes its body. And in Indian context, there is a belief that there are 300,000 cows, there are 300,000 gods and goddesses shelter in a cow, and all the 300,000 gods and goddesses would have touched me. And very painfully expresses that in Indian society that there is a discrimination on God and goddesses also based on. Some people who are born in a lower caste, they are not allowed to enter into the temple. So that he is expressing, they God and goddesses, they themselves can't come and touch me if I was born in tree. Whenever the sacred cow itches, it comes to me and scrapes its body to me, all the gods and goddesses would have touched me. There is no discrimination. There is no separation. There is no purification or defilement. These defilement and purifications are an abstract ideas. They have existed here. These are the unethical and prejudices existed in only human, in human beings, not in any other creatures in the nature. Again, at the end of the poem, it's, you know, he says that who knows at the end, at the last stage of its life, after complete drying the tree and its trunks and its branches may cut into little pieces, hack into little pieces, chop into little pieces, and it can become a bier, bier for a sinless body, where a corpse, a dead body can be kept and taken. And it can help in that way also. And so that I could have become bier for a sinless body, in that way also I could have purified. So, through this poem is keeping, Murnapur Chinnaswamy is keeping before the readers that understand the cruel system, an inhuman system that existed in the Indian society based on caste, is completely against of that. The discrimination, that inhuman is not existed in nature, then why it existed only in human beings, only in society? So that is trying to open our eyes that we should not follow the caste system, or no, we should not practice the discrimination based on caste. So because we are all blessed with same rights and privileges, so that we should treat everyone equally. That is his intention of writing this poem if I was a tree. Let me read the poem. Let me read line by line and explain you. That before going to read the poem, there is a pre-reading activity. That do you think that being a tree is more convenient than being a human being? How human beings are convenient in whatever ways they are convenient, and how tree is convenient. And he asks us to understand or to just imagine that is it tree is more convenient than human being, or do you think being a tree is more convenient than a human being? But in the view of Murnagudu Chinnaswamy, he says that yes, being a tree is more convenient than being a human being, instead of a human being. So as I said, that the poem completely expressing, it is depicting the inhuman or evil system of discrimination that they has been practicing on the name of caste. So that he is expressing his anger, his disappointment, and his frustration through this poem. Let me read the poem. See page number 54. If I was a tree, is assuming, is imagining, and he wanted to be a tree. If I was a tree, the reality is that he is not a tree, but if I was a tree, rather than being born as a human being, if I would have born as a tree, what would have happened? How tree would have been more convenient than human being? That he discusses. If I was a tree, the bird would not ask me before it built its nest what caste I am. This is the reality is expressing that if I was a poet, Murnagudu Chinnaswamy, I means he, if I was born, if I means here, poet himself, if I was born as a, no, if I was a tree, the birds would not ask me, me means him, before it builds a nest, which caste I am. It means that the upper class, or you know, there is a hierarchy in India, in Indian context, in Indian custom, tradition, from centuries, that there are hierarchies. High caste people, high class people never mingle with, never allow the lower class to be with them. They never allow them to come into their houses. But here birds, before going to build their nest on tree, they would have not asked the caste of the tree. Then when sunlight embraced me, when the sunlight embraced, when it hugs, when it meets the tree, my shadow would not feel defiled. The shadow of the tree would not defile. Defiled means becoming impure, or you know, say that damaging the purity, or you know, spoiling, damaging the purity, damaging the purity, defiled. When sunlight embraced me, my shadow would not feel defiled. My shadow would not. So both the sunlight and the shadow of the tree together, they have embraced. Both of them have never, they never felt the defilement. Next he says, my friendship with cool breeze and the leaves would be sweet. again here being sea, being tree, in these many ways it is convenient. It is convenient to the birds. And if the sunlight embraced it, the shadow of the tree would never feel defiled. And then he says that my friendship with the cool breeze and the leaves. Here my means the trees. My friendship, whose friendship here? Trees' friendship with cool breeze and leaves would be sweet. The company of birds, the company of breeze and the leaves would be sweet. The cool breeze means light breeze. A pool of light, light wind. My friendship with the cool breeze and the leaves would be sweet. Raindrops would not turn back, taking me for a dog eater. So here, dog eater means, no, being born in a low caste. Being born in a low caste. Raindrops would not turn back. These are the natural activities happening in the nature. Sunlight will embrace the tree. And the raindrops, the cool breeze and leaves, like the company of the tree, it's a sweet company. And raindrops would not turn back. The raindrops which fall on the tree, they never consider the tree. Here, as a dog eater, you are born a lower caste. It never maintains its distance. It never does any discrimination or separate favoritism. So it likes the company of the tree and it never considers it as a dog eater. Dog eater means which is another way of treating someone in a bad way. Dog eater means a human being considers another human being in a bad way, that we never consider him as equal him. Dog eater. He is no more equal to me. Or considering someone as a low caste. So that raindrops we have not turning back this, you know, on this tree, considering it as a dog eater. When I branch out further from my roots, Mother Earth would not flee, shouting for a bath. Flee. Mother Earth would not flee for shouting for a bath. Flee means running away. Running out. Or no, run away from place, flee. So if tree starts spreading, or no, its branches inside the earth, or no, its another no branches started spreading, my no, its roots, Mother Earth would not flee. The Mother Earth, he says that the Mother Earth is, Earth is in Indian context, you know, it is Earth is considered as a mother, motherland, Mother Earth. She would not flee shouting for a bath. Why usually, you know, in this, see how it is a poem which is, it is a mirror that these inhuman activities are happening every now and then in the society. What are they? Before going to stay in somebody's home, we ask the caste of that person. Before inviting someone into our house, we ask the caste of that man, even though we are human beings. And we, before going to touch someone, shake somebody's hand, and we feel defilement, but that never happens in the nature. The sunlight never feels, after embracing the shadow of the tree, never, or no, shadow of the tree never defile, you know, it never feels defilement. He says that when I branch out further from my roots, Mother Earth would not flee shouting forever. She never run away. The person who touches the higher caste person who touches lower caste by accidentally, he runs The mother earth, she doesn't do that. She never flee. She doesn't flee, and you know, and she doesn't shout for taking bath, because there is no discrimination. There is no separatism. Everybody is treated in the nature. Everything is treated equally. But only that inequality in human existed in the human society. The sacred cow would scrape her body on my bark. So bark means the trunk of the tree or outer part of the tree. When cow, whenever it feels itches, it comes to the, you have noticed this, either to the hole of, you know, or to the trunk of the tree or to the wall. Sometimes this cow scrapes themselves. They rub their body whenever they feel itches. The sacred cow would scrape her body on my bark, scratching wherever it itched, and the 300,000 gods sheltering inside her would touch me. So this is a satirically telling that on the name of God and Goddess, there is a discrimination. And even if you see the tree, if you know a sacred cow, a holy cow, in Indian context, we believe that there are 300,000 gods sheltering in cow. And whenever it feels itches, it comes to the bark of the tree and scrapes its body. And what happened? All the 300,000 gods were sheltering in that cow, touching the tree. And whereas some of the lower caste people are not allowed inside the temple, and God themselves, 300,000 God, they themselves come and touch the tree. So satirically is telling that there is no such discrimination, but why existed? We have created them. They are unethical. They are prejudiced. We have created this illusion, or you know, abstract feelings like defilement or purification. Again, he says that at the end of the poem, who knows at the end, hacked into pieces of dry wood, hacked. Who knows at the end, hacked into little pieces. Hacked means cut or cutting little pieces. Now chopping out or cut or chop. A tree, when it completely dries, what happens? We cut it and chop it. Hacked into pieces of dry wood, burning in the holy fire, burning in the holy fire. While doing at the time of puja, in Indian context, we see that there will be a holy fire, that there will be thrown some pieces of the dry woods. Dry woods have been thrown in that holy fire, and we consider that, you know, that is a holy fire. And what happens? That the pieces, that a tree which has been hacked, cut into little pieces, have been thrown in that holy fire. In that way also it becomes purified. It becomes pure. Burning in the holy fire, hacked into little pieces of dry wood, burning in holy fire, I might be made pure, and then it can become pure. Then at the end, all becoming the mirror for a sinless body. So here beer means a frame, wooden frame which is movable, where a dead or a corpse can be kept on that and taken to graveyard. So here he says that are becoming the bier for a sinless body be bore. Again, bier, B-E-A-R, bier's past participle is bore. Past participle of the bier is bore. Be bore on the shoulders of four good men. So here, at the end of the poem, Sunlight embraces it. The cool breeze and leaves love the sweet company of the tree. And raindrops fall on it, and they never turn back and say that you are a dog eater. And when it started spreading its branches, Mother Earth never flee and shout for taking bath. And a sacred cow, whenever it feels itches, it comes to the tree and it scrapes its body to the bark. And there 300,000 gods were sheltering, and that body would have been touched with the bark of the tree. In that way also it is convenient. And who knows at the end when the tree's lifespan is end over and it has been cut, hacked into little pieces, chop out. Then in that way also it is convenient, because the dry woods have been thrown in that holy fire. In that way also it would have become pure. And at the end, who knows, are becoming a bear. Bear means, as I said, that it is a frame, wooden frame, a movable frame, where a dead body, a coffin, a dead body can be kept on it and taken to graveyard. In our four men hold it on their shoulder. In that way also a tree can become convenient, in which way human beings are convenient. So Mudnapudu Chinna Swami says that tree is convenient in these many ways. Without having any inhuman experience, the discrimination, domination based on color, size, gender, habitat, in any way, but a tree is convenient in these ways. But where human being? Human being, every now and then we ask the caste. We never like somebody's embrace, touch. We never like somebody's company. Or we always blame or say others, that dog eater, low caste. And Mother Earth, we are all living on this earth, but there is no such that never makes any discrimination in the nature, then why this existed in only human beings? So the poem begins that if I was a tree, the bird would have not asked the caste of me before going to build their nest. The sunlight embraced me, the shadow of the tree would never feel defilement. My friendship with cool breeze and the leaves will be so sweet. The raindrops would never turn back and consider me, tell me that you are a dog eater. Or when I start spreading the branches, the Mother Earth would not flee shouting for a bath. Or a sacred cow, whenever it feels itches, it gives shelter to 300,000 gods and goddesses. It comes to me and scrapes its body to my bark, and then my bark would have been touched those 300,000 gods. And at the end, if I am cut, hacked into little pieces by falling in the or throwing in the holy fire, I would have become pure. And at the end, being a bear for a sinless body, and I would have been carried on shoulders of good men. In this way, tree is more convenient than human being. So my dear students, this will be asked for 5 marks. One is for 1 marks and 4 marks question on this poem. And overall, if you see the poet trying to or is attempting to convey in the nature, and he asks that why and if nothing discrimination existed in the nature and that shall not be practiced in human being, in human, in society also. So it has been happening from so many centuries, but at least now onwards we should try to eradicate that discrimination based on caste and creed, so that we should create an equal society, a humanity based on humanity rather than caste. However, we are all blessed here with our own rights and privileges, and we should lead our life equally without discrimination, without discriminating, dominating, or doing favorism. We should lead our life and we should be more convenient than any other creatures on this earth. But the thing is that poet feels a shame being born as a human being, rather he wanted to be, you know, born as a tree. So he imagines that and he feels that if I was a tree, I would have been more convenient than the human being. So because human beings are, you know, divided, or they have, you know, discriminated themselves on the name of caste. So that should be removed from our mind, and we should lead our life equally, and we should give importance to humanity than caste. So I hope that you have understood the poem, If I Was a Tree. Once again read it and may underline some important lines here, and you know, find out their meaning and try to understand it. And this will be for 5 marks in the annual exam. And in next class we discuss An Old Woman, a poem by Arun Kolhatkar, and this is an outline summary and the explanation of poem If I Was a Tree. So in next class I'll come back to discuss another poem, An Old Woman. Thank you.